front of you. I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. Hallelujah, this morning. I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. Do you believe that this morning, that our God didn't bring us this far to leave us this morning? Do you believe that this morning? Hallelujah. That he didn't bring us this far to leave us. Hallelujah. So this morning, the word of the Lord, hallelujah, to us this morning. And if you heard all the songs previous to this that came up to this point, is, and today's sermon is, I sought the Lord and he heard me. Hallelujah. I sought the Lord and he heard me. And the scripture verse today is taken from Psalms 34, verse 4. And it says, I sought the Lord and he heard me. I sought the Lord and he heard me. So when he heard me, what did the Lord say? And delivered me from all my fears. Hallelujah. So there is a three-part prong in this scripture this morning. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears this morning. Glory be to Yahweh. Lord, I just want to thank you this morning for your download this morning. Lord God, as I decrease and you increase, have your way. Today, Lord God, I pray, Almighty God, that your word go forward and it will touch hearts of men and women this morning that are perplexed on every side. Hallelujah. They're struggling, oh God, because fear has crept in. Fear has taken over. But this morning, hallelujah, David said in Psalms 34, verse 4, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears this morning. I pray that that scripture wrap us up this morning in the mighty name of Yahweh. Hallelujah. We tell you thanks. Hallelujah. So David wrote the Psalms this morning. And in Psalms 34, the Psalms is dealing with fear and many things. So the Psalms, I'm going to just break it down for you. In verse 2, it invites the afflicted to hear and rejoice. In the fourth verse, the one that we're going to stay on today, it promises deliverance from all fears. In verse 6, it's speaks of deliverance from all troubles. Hallelujah. In 15, it assures us that God listens to the cry of the righteous. In 17, it gives the righteous hope that God would deliver them from all of their troubles. In 19, it recognizes that the righteous who face many troubles. Hallelujah. And in 19 again, it affirms that the wicked hate the righteous this morning. So in totality, Psalms 34 affirms that God is able to deliver us from any situation. Psalms 34 affirms that our God is able to deliver us from any situation. So what were the circumstances and conditions that led to the experience described in Psalms 34? Because there is foundational, there's context that we must understand. So the context and circumstances surrounding the Psalms are recorded in 1 Samuel 21, 1 through 15. In other words, the link between Psalms 34 and 1 Samuel 21 is found in the heading of Psalms 34, wherein New King James Version titles the Psalms, a Psalm of David when he pretended madness before Abimelech, who drove him away and he departed. So David went to Achish, the king of Gath, and not to Abimelech, as stated in 1 Samuel 21, verse 10. This raises the question of whether Achish and Abimelech are the same person or two distinct individuals. The answer is that both names were referenced in the same person. It referred to the same individual. Ashish is a given name, and Abimelech is a royal title that translates as Father King. According to the kingly protocol at the time, Ashish was addressed as Father King by his subjects. And according to 1 Samuel 21, 10 through 15, David fled from King Saul into Philistine territory to the city of God. David experienced the Philistine king, hallelujah, to accept him as a deserting soldier. However, the Philistine became suspicious that David was still a royalist of King Saul and that he was likely spying on them. David overheard their conversation and realized they were planning to kill him. Hallelujah, this morning. Soon, in order to avoid death, David pretended to be insane. So the first key point that I want to bring across to you is one can determine that David was caught between a rock and a hard place. I mean, how many of us this morning are caught between a rock and a hard place? So David's flight from King Saul into Philistine territory offered him no relief from his fears. He sought refuge in enemy territory, expecting them to help, but they too turned against him. The Philistines started to plot to kill him. It was like jumping from the frying pan into the fire. Hallelujah. He jumped right out of one territory hand, enemy hand, into the other. To put it any other way, David's situation was similar to the one described in Amos 5 verse 9, which states, it will be as though a man fled from a lion only to meet a bear. As though he entered his house and rested his hands on the wall only to have a snake bite him. Have you ever found yourself in a situation where everything you do seems to be working against you? Have you ever found yourself in such situations where everything is working against you? Have you ever been in a situation where something you believe will bring you relief turns out to be the greatest threat to your life this morning? Come on. I'm not the only one that's been through something this morning. Well, I'm here to tell you that you're not alone. Many people have been in similar or worse situation than yours. And God has always provided a way out. And he will also deliver you. It's a message this morning. God has always provided a way out. And he will deliver you. So, when his life was in danger, David pretended to be insane on the outside while pleading with God for deliverance on the inside. A lot of us know that outside presents a different picture from what the inside is doing. So David pretended to be insane on the outside while pleading with God for deliverance on the inside. David realized that relying on men, like many of us, relying on men for security is akin to relying on a broken reed. Hallelujah. He sought the Lord. Hallelujah. It's what he penned in Psalm 34, verse 4. I sought the Lord and he heard me and and delivered me from all my fears, my God. So David sought the Lord in the midst of all of his troubles. David made God his only refuge in times of trouble. So in Psalms 91 and verse 2, it says, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Mighty God of Zion this morning, will somebody say that? I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust this morning. It is a great reminder of why God is our refuge and fortress. It gives us confidence that no matter what happens or is happening, we are safe in the Lord's arms this morning. Glory be to Yahweh. We are safe in the Lord's arms this morning. Hallelujah. So what does it mean this morning to say I sought the Lord? What does that mean? Because many of us this morning just recite this verse time and time again. But what does it mean to say I sought the Lord? But David turned to the Lord when his plans to escape his enemies came to naught. Ah, my God, like many of us do when we've tried everything. The old writer and the old people of old used to say, then try Jesus, mighty God of Zion. Why don't you try Jesus? You have tried everything. Now, why don't you try Jesus? So David turned to the Lord when his plans to escape his enemies came to naught, meaning that it didn't materialize. It did not work. And I want you to know that we shouldn't wait until we're at wit's end to ask God for help, because he's a present help in the time of trouble. So the Hebrew word translated as sought is defined as darash. And it means to diligently seek, inquire, or make inquisition of something. If that is the case, what does it mean to seek the Lord? To seek the Lord is to earnestly and fervently seek, consult, and trust him in all things and circumstances of our lives. It also means turning to God first. Turning to God first for our deliverance and our salvation. I want you to underscore that this morning. To seek the Lord is to earnestly and fervently seek, consult, and trust him in all things and circumstances of our lives. It means to turn to God first. To turn to him first. Not when you have tried everything. Now try Jesus. To sought the Lord, meaning to turn to him first. Oh no. Not when you've come to your wit's end. Turn to him first. So the enduring word, Bible commentary suggests that David sought the Lord, meaning look to him in loving trust, meaning that he trusts God, everything he put on God. The secret to overcoming fear is to turn to God in loving trust, saying, God, you got me. Hallelujah, this morning. You got me. So David acknowledges in verse 10 that trusting in God is a key that unlocks every good thing. Every good thing. It says the young lions lack and suffer hunger, But those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. That's what the word said. It's not what I say. That's what the word said. The young lions lack and suffer hunger. But those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. So what is the state of your prayer life? What do you do when you're fearful? Do you draw closer to God and pray more? Or do you complain about your situation? Reminisce on those. What do you do when trouble is at your door? Do you fold up and cry? Do you sort? Do you seek outside help? Do you complain? What do you do? Or do you draw closer to God and pray? So David prayed with all of his heart. Despite his affliction, fear. His fears increase his urgency and desire to seek God's intervention. That is what we need to do this morning. Underscore that. David prayed with all of his heart, despite his affliction and fear. Instead of being caught up in the fear and the affliction, David prayed, and he prayed with all of his heart. His fears increase his urgency and his desire to seek God's intervention. He entrusted the Lord in prayer and supplication for deliverance. He writes in Psalms 34, verse 1, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. Therefore, seek God at all times and in all circumstances. It is all part of fighting the good fight of faith this morning. What's in your mouth? When trouble is at your door, what's in your mouth? Are you like David and say, I will bless the Lord at all times? His praise shall continually be in my mouth. What's in your mouth? What words are you declaring and coming out of your mouth? Are you seeking God or you're seeking somebody else to rescue you? What's in your mouth? What are your words saying? But here is what God says. When you bless the Lord at all times, and when his praise shall continually be in your mouth, and when you seek God at all times and all circumstances, you know what the Bible says? And he heard you. Just like David said, and he heard me. So David's next statement is, and he heard me. Not mine. This is what's been. And he heard me. So what exactly does he mean by that? David affirms here that God heard him during his trials. Hallelujah, this morning. That God is hearing some of you during your trials when you seek him and diligently pursue him. He's saying, and he heard you. Hallelujah, this morning. David affirms that God heard him during his trials. So David's declaration in Psalms 34, verse 4 is one of the strongest biblical evidence that God hears and responds to our prayers, no matter how difficult our circumstances may be. Hallelujah. So what does it mean in Psalms 34 and verse 4? I'm breaking it down for all those that don't comprehend and understand what the Lord is saying, that God heard me. Hallelujah. It means that David received. David received underscore, received an answer from God. And the God considered David's request for intervention. Oh, my God, my God, my God, my God. I want somebody to light up the chat room this morning. That God, oh, my God, that I'm going to receive an answer from God. And God is considering my request for intervention this morning. Glory be to God. That's what Psalm 34 verse 4 mean. That God heard me. Hallelujah. No matter what I'm going through, he's hearing me this morning. Glory be to Yahweh. He heard me. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, mighty God, pull down the answer this morning because he heard you. He heard you. It means that David received an answer from God. And so with you, you will receive an answer from God. Oh my God, because God considered David's request for intervention. God is considering your request for intervention, whether it be in your marriage. Hallelujah. God is intervening right now, whether it be in your finances. God is the great Jehovah Jireh, your provider, and he's intervening right now, whether you need healing. Oh my God, he's Jehovah Rapha. He's the one who healeth thee. He's intervening right now. Ah, God heard you. God heard you. God heard me. Mighty God, I am assured this morning that he hears me. Hallelujah. And he's considering my request. And he's intervening this morning. So the hearing mentioned in this verse is a type of hearing that is accompanied by divine action. This morning, you're going to walk away with a brand new understanding of who God is. So the hearing mentioned in this verse is a type of hearing that is accompanied by divine action. Divine action. But the Lord is not going to sit down. So God, in other words, heard and acted. Oh my God, somebody needs to get excited this morning. God heard and acted. God heard and delivered David in the midst of his adversaries. Hallelujah. He acted in the midst of adversity. Oh, he acted in the midst of David's fear. Mighty God, God heard and delivered David in the midst of adversity. Then why did God have to wait until David was in danger before rescuing him? Why? Or be more precise, why does God permit hostilities to come to us before saving us from them? This morning, I want to notify that God didn't delay his deliverance because David never sought his help in the first place. Because remember what David first did. He went and found refuge elsewhere. It was when he came to the end of his rope. Hallelujah, this morning. It's when all of his tactics ran out. He sought God. So this morning, could it be that that's what's happening with you and me? So therefore, we cannot say that God delayed his deliverance because we never sought him.
One time though.
Hallelujah. We never sought his help. In the first place, it was when everything else failed is when we ran into him. So now, in terms of why God waits until we are the midst of a fiery furnace before rescuing us, I would say that God's deliverance is always right on time, mighty God of Zion. He's always right on time. In fact, to save his faithful from the flames, God enters the fiery furnace before they do. Hallelujah. This morning, God is saying that I've already entered long before you are, because I presented myself in the mighty name of Yahweh. I've gone ahead of you. So in fact, to save his faithful from the flames, God enters the fiery furnace before you do. He's already there. He's already there. And I want you to know this morning that God's power is most visible when we're at our most vulnerable. Yes. When you're at your weakest points. When you're at the lowest low. So the Apostle Paul expresses this glorious truth in his words in 2 Corinthians 12 and 9. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Your Father says this morning to you that I want you to know that God doesn't rescue us from afar. He doesn't stay from afar and rescue you. He chooses to be present with us in our despair. He's present. He's right there. He saves us so that we can honor him. Psalms 91. Verse 15 expresses against us. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Hallelujah. So in our trials, God is with us. He's with you. He's with you this morning. That means that God is intimately familiar with our problems and our anxiety. He knows what you're going through. God understands your difficulties because he's a part of you and he's fighting for you. As he says, I will deliver you. That's the promise. I will deliver you. So whenever you feel alone, call on his name whenever you feel alone, because he will deliver you. Because God invites us to call him. Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you. You shall glorify me. That's what Psalms 50 verse 15 says. Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. Are you calling upon him? You're calling upon him, because he will deliver you when you call upon him. And he's telling us to call upon him. Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. The next point is, and deliver me from all my fears. Going back to our reference text this morning, Psalms 34, verse 4. David also admits that his fears are terrified and it ignited fear and terror in him. It agitated fear in David. David recognized God as the only one who can free him from all of his fears. To David, his enemies were after his soul, and only divine intervention could save him from them. So David deliberately uses the parallel form, fear. And in this verse, to emphasize the magnitude of his anxieties, my God. So as a plural form suggests, David had many, many, many fears and dreads. And David's fear constituted all that he apprehended from Saul, and again from all he dreaded when he found that Abimelech would not harbor him, but drove him from him. So in Psalms 34, David asked for protection and deliverance from all of his fears, not some, but all of his fears, which he describes in the following way. Verse 4 is all fears. Verse 7 and 18 is troubles. And verse 20 is afflictions. This morning, it cannot be disputed that David was facing many dangers and fears at the time, at this time in his life. But later in the same chapter, David writes, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. That's in 19. Somebody need to praise Yahweh this morning, because after, oh my God, the darkness, there is light. My God, in your midnight right now, your fears are upon you, but morning is coming, and the Lord is saying, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but I, the Lord, delivereth him out of them all. Hey, hallelujah. Mighty God, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Ah, my God, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. The Lord will deliver you out of them all. Oh, my God. So the phrase all fears refers to the totality of fear in all of its forms and shapes. The Lord delivers us. The Lord delivers us from the totality of fear. Oh my God. What's your fear this morning? Because the total fear, all your fears, the Lord will deliver you from all of them, no matter what you're going through, because the Lord said, and I'm going to remind you again in Psalm 34 and 19, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. My God, all of them. It didn't say some of them, because the writer could have said some, but it says, but the Lord delivers him out of them all, underscore all. But and then you're going through, he's going to say, oh, I'm going to deliver you out of them all this morning. Ooh, mighty God. So the psalmist celebrates God's deliverance from fear and death. My God, in these words, in Psalms 23 and verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Do somebody understand this morning? Again, in Psalm 27 and verse 1, it says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom shall I dread? Oh, glory be to Yahweh. Come on, light up the chat room this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody need to wrap themselves in Psalm 23 and verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. My God is with me. Thy rod and their staff and thy staff, oh my God, they comfort me. And Lord, because you are the light, my is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is a stronghold of my life. Whom shall I dread? My God, wrap yourself in Psalms 27, verse 1. My God. So this morning, I want to remind you that we must always seek God's help when we face adversity. David conquered his fears by placing his confidence in God. We also need to discover that seeking and living for God is a key to living without fear. Yes. We have to discover that when we seek and live for God, these are the keys to living without fear. Because God is capable. He's more than capable to rescue us from all of the situations that have us bound. Oh, glory be to Yahweh. So this morning, what are your worries? Because the Lord wants to free you from those fears. He wants to remind you that he said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you, my child, will fear no evil. Because I am with you, said the Lord of hosts this morning. My rod and my staff, they will comfort you. Because I am your light and your salvation. So whom shall you fear this morning? Because I am the stronghold of your life. Whom shall you dread? This morning, the Lord delivers you from all of your fears. Seek the Lord, and he will deliver you from all of your fears. Ooh. The world got a lot to say. Yeah. We have a lot to say. But what does God say? We have a lot to say sit on the couch. What does God say? He's saying this morning, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. But thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, and comfort me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is a stronghold of my life. Whom shall I trust? Because many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers you and I out of them all. Morning, many. Oh, so the world is saying that, you're burdened down, you're distressed. But the Lord said, yes, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but I, God, will deliver you out of them all this morning. Glory be to Yahweh. The Lord will deliver. He will deliver. He will come through. Hallelujah. This morning, glory be to Yahweh. He said, call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. That's what he said. Hallelujah. This morning, call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. He further went on to say, he shall call upon me, and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble, and I will deliver him and honor him. I, my God. Oh, glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. You shall call upon him. Replace he with you. I shall call upon him. Ah, my God. And God said, I, God, will answer him. I, God, will be with him in trouble. I, God, will deliver him. Hallelujah, this morning. God will deliver you. That's God's promise this morning. That's his promise. Ah, because he says, my grace is sufficient for you. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Oh my God, my grace. My grace is sufficient for you. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Are you in the valley this morning? Are you in the valley this morning? Because the Lord says, the young lions lack and suffer hunger. But those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good. Any good thing. But those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good. This morning. I pray that you're blessed. I pray that you're blessed by this word and you find new meaning. This morning in Psalms 34, verse 4, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all. But there's a part that you and I must play. Because if you break up this very simple, powerful verse, there's three things that happened. He said, I sought the Lord. Point number one. And what happens when we seek the Lord? Point two says, he heard me. And because he heard me, he took action. And the third part says, and delivered me from all my fears. So sought, heard, delivered. Signed, sealed, delivered. Sought, heard, and delivered. But we got a job to do this morning. We got to seek the Lord first. And when we do, he hears us. And he not only hears us, he hears our pantering and our crying. But the last final act that he does, he delivers us from all our troubles, all our fears, and all our anxieties this morning. I pray that you're blessed by this word. I pray that you find new meaning, a new action to take. As this word outlines our part, God's part, which equals the result. My favorite formula. Our part, God's part, which equals the result. Sought is me. But when I seek him, what happens? He hears me. He not only hears me, but he delivers me from all of my fears. Father, I thank you this morning that your word is quick. It's sharper than any two-edged sword. I pray that your people this morning will find refuge in your word, Lord. I pray this morning that the instructionals that you have given to us this morning, Lord God, we will find new meaning in it, and we will apply it to our daily walk with you. Father, because you said, I sought the Lord, and you, Lord, heard me, and you delivered me from all of my fears. Whatever the fears are this morning, when we seek you, you hear us, and you deliver us from all of our fears this morning. This morning, for such a one as going through and is weighted down by the word, Father, let your voice speak aloud in their ear this morning. Let your voice be the only voice that they hear this morning, Lord. Touch, set free, and deliver. You're the God of the deliverance this morning. And we know that when we seek you, you hear and you deliver. So Lord, touch such a one this morning. Take away every fear, every doubt, and replace it with, when you seek me, I hear you. And I not only hear you, but I deliver you. I thank you, Lord, for what you are doing and what you are about to do, because you are the great I am. I give you all the praise and all the glory and all of the honor. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Come on, people of Yahweh. Just give the Lord a shout of praise this morning. A shout of praise this morning, because we serve the true and living God this morning. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Come on. Just shout aloud this morning. Shout aloud this morning.
Hallelujah.
Serve the true and living God. Hallelujah. And he hears you.
Hallelujah.
He hears you. Seek him like never before. Hallelujah. If you're looking for a church home this morning, Recharge Ministry is here. And it is a ministry that our God had designed for such a time as this. He has birthed this ministry for such a time as this. Hallelujah. We are just his hands and his feet in the earth realm, but he is our all in all. And we give him all the praise and all of the glory. Be blessed today.